Got it.
Yeah. Anything?
All right, here we go. Take one, take two, take three. Yeah, well, basically I had the idea like 5 years ago, and I sat on it for a while because I wasn't in a, you know, I wasn't at a job that allowed me to do it. I didn't have the tools yet. About 2 years ago, I decided it's time to quit. It's time to do what you want to do. So I quit, bought the wood from a local reclaim store. You know, not so much realizing how much work it would really take to get reclaimed wood back to what it looks like in that table. I was buying tools like as I went. Like I would save money, buy another tool so I could do another part of it. But I never had like all the tools I needed, so it took a long time. I'm an 80s kid, you know. Maybe I'm a 90s kid who was still living in the 80s, because like I never had a CD player. I never had a CD player in my car or even a boombox with a CD player. That was how I listened to music. You know, I like art and everything, but I think stuff should be functional as well. You might walk up at first, and then until you set your drink on it or look down, you're just looking at a rectangle, but then you're like, whoa, this gear drain, like, holy crap, that's the whole thing. How big should a coffee table be? How many times do I need to multiply this tape using the micrometer and measuring everything out and scaling everything out? I did different sketches of it, try to take the most iconic pieces you remember, because if you look at the tape, everyone is almost different. But I just wanted to clean it up and show you the most important parts of the tape, the parts you would look and be like, that's a tape. As far as meeting all these people, and not just anybody that can do it, but like the right person to do it, somebody that you trust to do a good job every time, somebody that you want to support because you believe in what they're doing too. That's kind of the thing I'm going through right now. When I put the original one together, I was clamping up each piece just straight to the next piece, but to be mass produced, this has to have a different system. So, you know, there's a new system now where everything connects with a dowel inside. You don't see it, but it's part of making the process easier for somebody to make and repeat it perfect every time. The tolerances you need on that piece of glass and that angled cut and splitting right in, if it's off at all, you're not going to be able to flip it and put the glass on both sides. So if it doesn't flip, it's not the true tape. It has to flip. It's a tape. Yeah, everything's going to be local. It's important to me because I want to see every part of the process. I don't want it made somewhere where I can't see how it's made and be there if something's even just, you know, a tick off. It has to be the same every time, and I don't trust that to be done anywhere else. And I think everything can be made in America, so I want to support that. And I don't want to drive far to go to work. I want to work right here. This is where I live. This is my home. This is the community I want to support. I just want it to be like a piece that when people are at your house, you're proud it's there and they're excited to see it. And you know, I want it to have a story. And whether you're into hip hop or country or jazz or whatever, it's gonna be your story and your connection with tape and with music and like kind of a time. I understand not everybody can afford this table, but if you like it, if you believe in the project, liking it on Facebook and telling your friends about it or tweeting about it, anywhere you can get the word out, if you believe in this project, you're helping. We appreciate that.
Yeah!
Yeah, nice.
And there was a little smoke too.
That was
cool. I think that works.